What's good with the gang? What's good with the squad? What's good with the nation? It's your boy Scoop. And you already know what time it is, man. We're back at you on Scoop Squad TV, man. And I just want to come and talk to my people, man. I want to come and talk to the squad, man. Give y'all my opinion on the shenanigans that I just seen here on this stream with Academics and 6ix9ine, man. 6ix9ine album drop. Academics stream 6ix9ine's album.
Some shit, but like, don't put what? I said, just play me what you got so far. He said, yo, I got like, you know, I got some shit, but niggas want to see the big names. I said, I don't give a fuck about the big names. I don't care.
Given his story behind the songs that's on the album, pretty much saying different scenarios of different people getting cut off the album, album songs getting switched up, you know, just things of that nature. Songs that ain't been on the album, artists that ain't on the album was supposed to be on the album. That was crazy. But Academics in this mode, you know what I'm saying? Sipping this Henny. Shout out to Henny Demics, man. He just doing his thing. Listen to his music on Twitch. 6ix9ine goes live. Everybody's on the chat. Oh, 6ix9ine going live. 6ix9ine going live. 6ix9ine going live. Everybody switch over to 6ix9ine live. This man is drunk somewhere in New York, it look like.
Yo. Okay. I give him. Whoa. Hey. Hey. Yo. Yo, they can't fuck with you.
Yo, yo.
Yo, yo. Niggas is still rocking APs.
You know what I'm saying? Him and some other young brother and a few older people. You already know he had the protection out there. CIA, FBI, whatever the fuck. Well, whoever is protecting him probably had the whole radius on block. So can't nobody get in. You know what I mean? Money is a motherfucker. Hey, but so instead of 6ix9ine enjoying the fact that he has a new album out. You know what I'm saying? Enjoying the songs. He was at first, you know what I'm saying? But it was like, it was a little jokey joke. You know what I'm saying? You could tell he was drunk. You could tell he was drunk as hell. Damn near motherfuckers slipping through the cracks like, hey, you know what I'm saying? You got security back there trying to stop people from trying to, you know what I'm saying? There was a few, you know, a little couple homeless motherfuckers it looked like, or just some, you know what I'm saying? Some older motherfuckers that really ain't supposed to be a threat, but really can be a threat. Who knows, you know what I'm saying? Because Brady put up and he put up with a speaker, so instead of them using that person with that good speaker to play his own music and to promote his own album because they was playing the music from the truck, instead of them using that speaker, here goes 6ix9ine wanna be a fucking head honcho boss nigga, or you know what I'm saying, trying to still be streets with this shit. We know you're not in the streets, man. You had your chance and you blew that, bro. You blew that. But some way he just wanted to disrespect Dirk again, you know what I'm saying, by saying F Newski.
Nah, fuck that. Yo, what's going on, baby? What's going on, baby? How you chillin'? Yo, download that shit. Download the album. Yo, play The Voice. Yo, you a feeling little Dirk? We gonna play The Voice. Play The Voice.
You got speakers. You got speakers for a little.
Okay, ready? Yo, play little Dirk.
Play that Newski.
Let's listen to the voice of the. Yeah. Giving you plays, nigga. We helping you.
Your label decided that the budget they gave us was out of their league, so I'm sorry you couldn't drop your album.
Rest in peace, Newski.
Rest in peace,
Newski. I was going through that pain alone. I was going through that phase alone. We all changed, you see I changed alone. People tonight barely changed their clothes. You know damn right you was wrong. I was tired, they didn't realize. So
Thank you, brother.
King
New York. Yo, listen to the album. Just listen to it.
I saw your story from my apartment.
Here we go. Here we go.
My man. Yo, yo, play.
I don't like playing this.
Yo,
yeah.
Yo, say it one more time.
Fuck dirt.
Hold on, let me get you.
Say it. Fuck dirt.
What happened?
Fuck dirt.
Fuck dirt.
No, don't say that.
Yeah, let's get it.
Dirt is cool.
Yo.
Yo,
new CK. Loosey pack.
Fuck Dirk, plays music, trying to do little funny shit, you know what I'm saying? Disrespectful shit at that. Like sending baby shots and shit. Like it's just crazy. And it's like, that's not gonna get you nowhere. But he know people like me and everybody else that does YouTube is gonna tap in and talk about this shit. And this is exactly what he won't, you know what I'm saying? So, it comes with a price, man. Everything comes with a price. It might not happen fast, but it will happen soon. There's always an outcome to everything, man. And all I'm saying is, if you got a fan base, keep that fan base. There's no need to try to be something you're not. There's no need to keep trying to befriend or friend next motherfucker because of your situations, you know what I'm saying? And the shit that you did. And instead of you being real about the situation, you want to be funny about it in videos and shit, bringing up people, dead people. They don't even know you exist, you know what I'm saying? They don't even fucking know you, but you want to talk about dead people because you ain't got no dead homies and ain't nobody disrespecting. What dead homie you know of 6ix9ine that somebody can disrespect right now and it's going to mean something? You know what I'm saying? It's going to put a meaning behind it. Come on. All that shit that he did, that it's over with. You know what I mean? Keep your fan base. Keep that. But you keep on going at motherfuckers' heads that's really in this shit, that's really street and solidified. Hey, man. I can only say so much, man. I just wanted to give my opinion on this shit, though, man, because it's just crazy how I seen that. It's like, and you out there, though, like, he out there drunk as shit. Though, if you look at these videos, that's up, man. You can tell he's drunk as hell, and he just feel like he on top of the world, or he just feel untouchable. People is basically pumping his head up. You know what I'm saying? Pumping his head up with a whole bunch of bullshit. Now he still feel like that nigga. It is what it is, though, man. I want y'all to also take a look at what Academic said after he saw 6ix9ine live and him disrespecting Newski.
I'm hoping, and I don't know what mood he's in tonight. I'm hoping that's not just of everybody just kind of gassing him up or blah, blah, blah. And, you know, so I will try to speak to him whenever I can. I mean, it seems like he was trying to add me. I don't know what happened with that. 6ix9ine knows I fuck with him a lot. But, like, I'm not the person to try to lead him down a speedy downfall, nothing like that. I don't like when he's talking about Newski in the way he is. He's gonna do what he does. Not saying I could change his mind, but I hope he understands a little bit, you know. And some of the stuff, like, you know, even what I saw just now and before, I don't like
his whole energy and demeanor changed. At first it was, oh yeah, you know what, we up, you know what I'm saying, shout out, Child 6ix9ine, we did this shit, you know what I'm saying? Then after he saw that bullshit, he was like, you know what I'm saying? He's getting himself into situations that he don't need to be in. And academics understand and knows that he don't need to be in this situation. That's why he had to talk about it and say, I don't like when 6ix9ine disrespects them. I don't like when 6ix9ine does this about this situation, because then it puts me in the forefront of now I'm a target basically because I'm with you. You know what I'm saying? So it's coming back to 6ix9ine. Everything is slowly starting to come back to 6ix9ine when you think about it. From the Chicago videos and shit, it's like now you're starting to see it with your own eyes and actually be a target in this shit, and you're trying to back yourself out of it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I do what I do, but I ain't, you know what I'm saying? I ain't no street active nigga. I ain't disrespecting y'all. His part is his part. My part is my part. You know what I'm saying? I love the music and I promote the music, but the streets and the violent shit, I don't do. That's why you gotta understand when the fuck you use your mental, man. And Ak is using his mental on that because he know he don't want to get a part of that. He don't want to be another pack. He don't want to be a pack. You know what I'm saying? He don't want to be the next pack. Why? He got 6ix9ine out there and his people out there screaming fuck Dirk like they really about that shit, like they really gone, you know what I'm saying? And it's sad to see, but that's what it is now. And I just hope the kids and the youngsters that's watching don't fall for that bullshit ass trolling shit that he got going on, man. Real deal Holyfield. That's all I gotta say, man. Shout out to the gang.